G'day and welcome to this very special edition of Words and Numbers. For today, our All-Australian Words and Numbers champion is going to be taking on the Countdown champion of England, UK. So without any further ado, let's meet the protagonists. Yes, from Sydney, New South Wales, our Australian champion, Bruce Thompson. Yes. And Bruce works as a lifeguard on Bondi. His interests include women, drink, and Aussie rules. Eh, okay then. And now to meet a very special guest from Chipping Sudbury in England, UK, we have Tarquin Iolanthe Dilsworth. Right, yes. Okay, it's Tarquin there. Yes, Tarquin is currently doing postgraduate studies at King's College, Oxford. His interests include medieval history, 13th century literature, and the works of Geoffrey Chaucer. Actually, Tarquin, that's something you have in common with my good lady wife. She's a big fan of Geoffrey Chaucer. Reads him on holiday. Cain and Abel, first of all, equals, not a penny more, not a penny less. Yeah. She was very upset when he ended up in prison now. Yeah, very upset about that. Anyway, let's move on. So, let's meet the rest of the team. In Dictionary Corner, we have our doyen of the dictionary, the lovely Nolene Hughes. Yes, and now the star of our show, our resident guardian of the dictionary, the one and only, Clyde Wimble. What you mate? How's it going? Last, but no means least, our words and numbers girl, the lovely Raylene Davis. Okay, so we're all set. So, Tarquin, as you're our special guest, you can take the first letters game.
Yes, thank you, Michael. Okay, Raylene, could I have, please, a consonant, a vowel, another vowel, a consonant, a vowel, another consonant. Oh dear, I've dropped a consonant. I'll have to bend over and pick it up. Ooh.
Hell, boys, we all know what this means. Ready, guys? Hell right, Clyde! My word, Raylene! That was some show you put on there, girl! You alright, Clyde? Yeah, I'll be fine, Mike. I'm not a young man anymore. Raylene, you're a fine looking woman. Now, Lean, perhaps you could give Clyde some hand relief. No, I don't mean that. I mean, can you flap something for him?
Nah, I didn't mean that. I meant with the dictionary. The book. The big heavy thing on the desk. Eh? The big heavy thing.
Is that better, Clyde? Good. Okay. Well, 30 seconds are up. Let's see what you got, boys. Bruce, what have you got for me? Well, Mike, I've got a four. Cats. Good on you, Bruce. Well done, Cobber. Let's see what the pom's got to say to that. Yes, Tarquin, what have you got for us?
Yes, Michael, I have an eight. Ecstatic.
Cripes, an eight. Don't think we've had one of them before. What do we think of that in Dictionary Corner? We don't think too much of it, Mike. We think somebody's being a clever dick. Well, Clyde, Well, perhaps Norlene can look it up in the book, the big everything. Norlene, look it up in the big everything. No, Mike, there's no need for that. We don't like clever dicks on this show. I'm disallowing it. Hey, disallowed. Right, sorry about that, Tarquin. Anyway, numbers game. Over to you, Bruce. Okay, Rylene. I'd like you to give me a big one, please.
Oh, Bruce, you are naughty.
Yeah, big one, Rylene. And five, not quite so big. Okay, so there we are. And the target is 124. Okay, 30 seconds. Off you go, boys. Okay, 30 seconds is up. What have you got for me, Bruce? Well, Mike, I've got 117. 100 plus 6 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1 plus the 5. 117. Good on you, Bruce. Well done, Cobber. Right, well, that's 7 away. What have you got for me, Tarquin?
Yes, Michael. Well, I have 124. That's 6 times 4 is 24, plus 100 gives 124.
Right, that's it, Mike. I'm disqualifying the pom. You, son, have been a clever dick one too many times. The pom's disqualified.
Can I interject here? I wish to interject.
Well, careful, son. This is a family show.
Yes, Michael. Well, I would just like to say that since the game started, I have had the letters girl flaunting her knickers at me. I have been the subject of unrelenting hostility from Dictionary Corner. I have had a perfectly good eight-letter word disallowed. And now I find I am disqualified for being too clever. I must say, Michael, I find this very, very disappointing. Very disappointing.
Oh, it's very disappointing, is it? Hey, well, I'll give you something to be disappointed about, you punk bastard. Ah. Clyde, no. No, leave him, Clyde. Bruce, grab him. No, not the punk. Grab Clyde. Oh, well, folks, I think we'll leave it there for today. We'll call it an honourable draw. Clyde, for God's sake, the pom's turning blue. See you tomorrow. Hopefully.